Wouldn't it be great if before you actually launched your idea, you could validate it, you could help some people and generate some seed capital to go pay for ads and software and things you need to grow your business? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how we do that. It's called a founding member launch, and it's going to completely blow your mind. One of the toughest things about launching something new, whether it's a course or a membership or a podcast or even a book, is wondering how will the market receive that. And so what a lot of people do, and this is the wrong thing to do, is we build that stuff in a vacuum. We don't get any feedback, we don't ask anybody, we just kind of guess and assume we know what the market wants and then hope we get it right the first time. But sometimes when we take it to the market and we launch, nobody likes it and the feedback can be brutal and nobody buys it, or they do buy it but the refund requests come in, or you get a lot of negative feedback or whatever. There's lots of bad things that can happen when you actually take your product to the market and it's not tested. So a really powerful strategy to use is what's called a founding member launch. Now, when I launched my membership in August of 2019, I did exactly that. I did a founding member launch. I got 39 members in the door. I really had no idea what I was doing, but I didn't charge very much. And I said, hey, you're going to help shape the future of what we're going to be building here together, and it's going to be really awesome and powerful. You pay a little bit lower price, you get lifetime access, your price is locked in for as long as you're a member in good standing, which means you don't leave or say something mean, and you can just stay at that price forever. And it was great because it helped validate the idea, it helped get some momentum going, and it helped me get some customers and helped me get some feedback of those people that were now one of the founding members. And what happened is, over the months, we were able to quickly iterate and make the program better and better and better based on the feedback of those founding members. Then we did an actual full ticket launch. A few months later, it was really successful, and now we were off to the races. My wife's parents live in a lake community. And they have kind of an old boat. Now, they bought the boat for not a lot of money, but it'd be something fun for us to do with the kids when we come visit. And so one day they were getting the boat ready to go out on the water, and the boat is not super reliable. And so what happened is most of the morning was spent cleaning the boat, getting all the cobwebs off, all the dust, all of the bugs, all that stuff, getting the boat ready to go, adding life jackets, blowing up inner tubes and inflatables and all that stuff. The kids were running around, a lot of energy, everybody's really excited to go into the water. And we load the boat on the trailer, attach the trailer to the truck, take the truck down to the loading dock, get the boat in the water, and wouldn't you know, the darn thing wouldn't start. That's kind of what it's like if you go to launch a course or a project or an idea and you don't get that initial feedback. In that example, wouldn't it have been great to know ahead of time that this thing's not gonna work and we could have saved a lot of time and effort and heartache and not even tried to launch the thing in the first place? And our courses and our ideas and our memberships and our programs are no different. What if we could test them ahead of time, make some money, start to help people, get feedback, get testimonials before we actually go launch the thing to the public? That's how a founding member launch works. So when my wife went to launch her course, the first thing we did was a founding member launch. And we actually made it very simple. So if you're wondering, was there a webinar? Was there a complicated multi-step funnel? Was there a direct mail strategy? Like, how did you actually do this? It can be really, really simple. In fact, we made it as simple as possible because she was kind of skeptical that it would actually work. So we made a Google document that outlined what we thought her program would be about. And we made a simple landing page in ClickFunnels. I mean, I am the funnel guy after all. So I had to make a very simple landing page. She shot a quick video about her vision for what the course was going to be about and the types of results they might be able to expect. She made it very clear nothing was built out yet, and then when they signed up, they would just have to watch these videos, give her feedback, be honest and be kind, and help shape the future of what her course was going to be about. In order to make it the most effective, powerful course about virtual events on the planet. So we had a Google document that outlined what was in the founding member course. We had the funnel page that they could access that Google document. They could read more about it if they'd like, and they had a short video that they could watch about the vision of what the founding member launch would be about. And then she did the simplest thing I could think of. She set up her paypal.me link on her page. If people watched the video and they liked what they saw, she only had 20 spots available. She filled all 20, so we didn't have, the 20 wasn't just a joke, she actually had 20 spots. We didn't get 21 people in. Once she got to 20, which was on the last day of her open cart period, we were full, which was really awesome and really validating that this idea definitely works. So there was a paypal.me button on the page. They clicked that button, they sent her the money for the founding member price, and then they were locked in. Now her full price, the plan for her course is it'll ultimately be, you know, $1,000 or more, and they only paid $100 to be a founding member. So that was the value proposition. They pay a lower price, they get the course when it's fully done and ready, she gets kind, helpful feedback, and lots of participation, and she gets testimonials. And that's the value proposition and why a founding member launch is so powerful. Once she filled her founding member launch, a really cool thing happened. She had 20 people pay $100, so she had $2,000 to go buy software, to go buy Facebook ads, to go buy any kind of little equipment she might need to actually start to shoot her course. She also got their feedback along the way, so every few days she would send a video with a very simple Google form. So if you're keeping score at home, so far, Google document is free, a PayPal link is free, Google form is free. She didn't have to buy a bunch of software to do the founding member launch, and it can be very, very simple. And honestly, she did have the ClickFunnels page, but she didn't need that. She just needed the Google document and the PayPal link, and that could have been the simplest way she could have possibly done it. She also could have posted a video on YouTube for free. Like, there's lots of resources that she could have used for free to spend $0, and she could have made, you know, $2,000 in her case, 20 people at $100 a piece, but you can do whatever you want. Then every few days she'd release a video and then get their feedback. And now she was starting to shape like a ball of clay. She was shaping and molding what her course was ultimately going to be like. It gave her a ton of certainty. It gave her a ton of confidence, a ton of feedback on her course as she was building it out. It was really different for her because she has a boutique business. She only has 5 or 7 clients at a time doing their in-person events. And now all of a sudden she has 20 customers, 20 human beings that have given her money, giving her feedback along the way. So there's some growing pains and there's some imposter syndrome and those things that you might be feeling as well if you did a founding member launch and you had a bunch of people staring at you now saying, what do you got? Give me your best stuff. And that pressure is to be expected. But just remember to stay connected to your goal and your vision of what you're trying to create. They give kind, helpful feedback. You give them the awesome course. So here's 3 steps on how to set up a founding member launch for yourself. Number 1, get really clear on the vision of what you're trying to create and get excited about it. That really is the first step. If you can separate the decision from the details, you're already winning. You want people to buy into the overall outcome. So for my wife, she's teaching people how to do virtual events, saying if you want to learn how to do a virtual event in your business, it's a problem we're solving, it's really exciting, and I'd love for you to join me on this journey. That's kind of the first decision. If they're in, then they're in. The rest is just some details, click here, watch this video, click this link, send me some money, and you're in. But sometimes we start with those details and we just overwhelm people with that. So the first thing you need to do is get clear on the vision of what are you doing? Why are you excited about it? What's the problem you saw in the world? What's the gap that you saw that you're going to fill with this thing you're making and how they can help shape the future of that? The second step is to do something I learned from Stu McLaren is you do the I'm thinking about post, okay? It goes like this. You post on social media. I'm thinking about putting together a group that has these types of characteristics that wants to solve this kind of problem. If I were to put together a group of people that are getting that problem solved together and show you all of my awesome secrets of all the times I've solved this problem that you just said you had, would that be interesting to anybody? So for me, I would say, hey, I've been behind the scenes for a few years running Facebook ads for some of the biggest companies and the biggest launches on the internet. And I haven't really talked about it a whole lot, but if I were to go behind the curtain and just show you how that all worked, are there any other business owners that I know that would just want to see how that goes? Comment below and I'll get you all the details, right? So you have some kind of script like that where you're just looking for guinea pigs. You're just thinking about it. I'm just thinking about putting the thing together and you just want to start to get some dialogue going. You want to start to get the conversations going. So that's the opposite of making a great sales page and a great complicated marketing funnel and driving a bunch of cold traffic to this page and hoping it converts. You're just thinking about it. The third and final thing you need is a Google document and a PayPal link. You need the Google document to share your vision. What wrong are you trying to make right? What's the gap that you see in the world that you're trying to fix? What's the problem that you're seeing the market go through? And then it's your own epiphany where you're saying, after talking to so many entrepreneurs that aren't sure how to host a virtual event, they're afraid of the technology, they're afraid of all of the different options out there, they're concerned about their future. They know events are a powerful way to connect and make money and grow a community of people. I decided I'm gonna do something about that. Introducing, she calls hers the Virtual Event Playbook Founder Circle, I think was the name of a lot of words. Virtual Event Playbook Founder Circle is what she called it. And it got people bought into the vision. And it's a very simple invitation saying, if you have this problem and you'd like to explore solving it together, then I would love to invite you in and we can work together to get that problem solved. Here's what's in it for you. You get a low price and lifetime access, and you get to shape the future. People love to give input and feedback. Here's what's in it for me. I get a testimonial, I get your honest, kind feedback, and I get $100 or whatever you want to charge for your founding members launch as well. And that's it. You just need those 3 things to run a successful founding members launch. My wife and I just used this founding member launch strategy not only to launch her course, but also as a key piece of the puzzle of a strategy that I call the sawdust strategy. Click here and you can watch that video next.